Hi, I'm Tim. Welcome to our channel and thanks for logging on. If you enjoy these videos, do me a favor and subscribe to our YouTube channel right here at Watchbox Reviews. I would really appreciate it and I promise to update daily. If you love this watch, you could see it and you could purchase it on our website, thewatchbox.com. And today we are discussing the wonderfully versatile Breitling Super Ocean Heritage 2, part of a rollout from Fossil World 2017. This watch is stainless steel, 42 millimeters, 14.3 millimeters thick, so hardly gargantuan by Breitling standards, and you can see across the wrist the 42 spans 51.4 millimeters with a broad and contemporary 22 millimeter spacing between the lugs. The watch is fitted with straight bars in vintage evocative fashion, and the entire timepiece is designed to evoke the late 1950s Breitling Super Ocean Reference 1004, which was the first of the Super Oceans, and that has always been the touchstone for the Super Ocean Heritage Collection. The bracelet that's fitted features not just that vintage evocative straight bar design, but also a mesh. And the mesh, again, something that you would have seen in 50s, 60s, and 1970s dive watches, is remarkable because it feels like silk on the wrist, but it gives you the security and solidity of steel. And it's even intuitive to size, as what appears to be fearsome at first glance is actually sized using conventional removable links that are fixed in place by screws, so it's a very user-friendly system. You have a simple deployment clasp with a clamshell lock, and as you can see, the clamshell lock on top of a polished clasp that internally features several different divots drilled as anchoring points for the bracelet. So in addition to removing many small individual links so you can really fine-tune the size, you also have the ability to change the anchoring point inside of the clasp. You close the clamshell and it stays resolutely shut. It's a simple but secure solution. The case band, as you can see, is a little bit more than the standard integrated profile that you'll get on, for example, a Rolex Submariner, where metal sweeps into metal. Here, Breitling breaks out the lugs, so they have more of a pronounced form and volume than on something like a Rolex Submariner. They're sharp and thrusting, and they do reference that late 1950s reference, albeit on a much grander scale and to a higher degree of finish. The owner of this watch did not properly love it. As you can see, original shipping stickers are still in place. I expect you to remove those stat and get into the water with this one. A simple no-guard crown profile, because after all, this is a vintage-inspired watch. If you look, you can see that the bezel is held in place by screws. As with Zinn, which uses a similar system, Breitling employs a captive bezel that is fixed to the case using screws rather than snapped into place, the result being that you must dismantle the bezel rather than simply snapping it off, whereas with an Omega, a Tag, or a Rolex, you can accidentally snap the bezel right off. That cannot happen with a Breitling captive bezel. It is very tough. For the Super Ocean Heritage 2, there is a ceramic bezel insert, so it is now highly scratch resistant. No more anodized aluminum. You also have a 120 click bezel. Let's hear it. It's solid, secure, and another evolution for the Super Ocean Heritage 2, we now have a little luminescent pearl in the bezel itself, so you can line it up with the broadsword style minute hand, and now you have a 0 to 60 minute timer. Granted, we're still looking at a minimally calibrated 50s style bezel, but you know where the quarters are located, and you can estimate the 5 minute increments. It's a wonderful alternative to a chronograph, because first of all, it times up to 60, most chronographs don't time 60 minutes, and it's not going to trouble you with the downstream maintenance costs of a chronograph. The dial, as with everything else about the watch, is historically inspired right down to the font used for the Super Ocean logo. You have a broad arrow style hour hand, and you have stick indices, but they are all applique rather than printed, and they are rhodium plated steel for a lovely shine with a gold Breitling B up at 12 o'clock. You have a date anchoring the dial at 6 o'clock, and a matte black base to reduce glare. 200 meters water resistant, there are luminescent indices outboard of the stick indices. Turn it all over underneath the case back. A surprise for 2017, you get a Tudor movement, a Tudor MT5612 doing business as the Breitling caliber B20, 70 hour power reserve, stop seconds, quick set date, shock resistant with a full balance bridge and a free sprung index, and anti-magnetic with a silicon hairspring. Pivoting on 28 jewels, it is a COSC certified Swiss chronometer and it's protected by a screw down crown. This watch gives you the works. the heart of a Rolex or a Tudor, and of course the exterior of a Breitling, and not just a Breitling, but a time-tested vintage design. It should be mentioned that since its debut in 2007, the Super Ocean Heritage has been Breitling's best-selling model line. This design, as well as the utility and the value, prove that there's a reason. See it and learn why on the Watch Box. The Breitling Super Ocean Heritage by Knight.